work, in a physicist's definition, is the energy transferred to an object by a force and is given in terms of a line integral of a vector field, which is the force. So I think now is a good time to discuss the work-energy theorem. So we're going to start with Newton's law, Newton's second law, that most of you know as F equals ma, okay? If we write that in vector form, it's the mass of an object times its acceleration, which is the derivative of its velocity, which is a vector with respect to time. And that's equal to whatever the external force is. We can use an identity here. I'm going to want to multiply both sides of this equation by v, take the dot product with v. So we can use an identity that if we look at v dotted with dv dt, this is actually equal to 1/2 d dt of v dotted with itself, okay? And this is just 1/2 d dt of the magnitude of v, the speed. Squared. Okay, so that's an identity we're going to use. So we multiply both sides of this equation by v, and we use v dot dv dt is this one. So the left-hand side then will become d dt of 1/2 m v squared. And the right-hand side, then, we just dotted this with v, will become f dot v, OK? To obtain the work-energy theorem, then, we integrate this from some initial time to some final time. So we have the integral from some initial time, t naught, to some final time, tf, of a derivative of something. So we're going to use the fundamental theorem of calculus here, mv squared dt. And that's equal to the integral from t naught to tf of f dot v. V now is dr dt, right? And then we're integrating dt. So this simplifies. We use the fundamental theorem of calculus here. So this becomes 1/2 m times the final velocity, magnitude squared, so the speed squared, minus 1/2 m times the initial velocity, magnitude squared, speed squared. And the right-hand side then becomes our line integral of a vector field. So it's the integral over the curve followed by the mass of f dot dr, OK? So what is this? This is the definition of the kinetic energy. So this is usually called Tf, the final kinetic energy, minus the initial kinetic energy. And this is what is called the work done by the force on the mass. So we have the work-energy theorem is that the work done by the force on the mass results in the change in the kinetic energy of the mass. Okay? That's the work-energy theorem. Okay, so let me summarize. At this point in the course, since we've learned what a line integral of a vector field is, I thought I would introduce to you the physicist's concept of work. Work is the line integral of a force, f dot dr, along the curve followed by a mass. And then the force then imparts energy to the mass and causes the mass to change its kinetic energy. the work-energy theorem is that the work done by a force on the mass causes a change in the kinetic energy of the mass. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.